The Stonecrest Podcast.
Spreading awareness within our community.
Presenting our invocation, Pastor Norman Thomas Jr., Senior Pastor, First Baptist Church, Gresham Road.
Good evening. Let us bow for a word of prayer. Our Father and our God, again, we want to say thank you for this day. We honor you for who you are, for being such an awesome and a wonderful God. We thank you for this occasion. Thank you for the city of Stonecrest. Thank you for all of its elected officials. Thank you for those who reside in the city of Stonecrest and for those who work in the city of Stonecrest as well. Father, I pray now that you would bless our mayor, that you bless the residents, bless those who serve in this community. I pray that your work would be done to create a more safe and orderly environment, a place where families can come and reside in peace, have fun, fellowship with one another. I pray, Father, that you would grant wisdom, knowledge, understanding, and courage to the leaders so that they can carry out the work that you've called them to do. We thank you for this occasion, and Father, we thank you for the opportunity to serve in a more excellent way. We pray that you have your way today. It is in your name that we pray. Let us all say together, amen.
Well, good evening, everyone. What a pleasure and honor it is today to introduce our wonderful mistress of ceremonies. Listen, nationally syndicated radio and television personality Sasha the Diva is one of the nation's most talented and hardworking personalities. Now, listen, she's recently completed two successful plus years on a stint of over 35 stations in the morning with Westwood One. As a co-lead of the morning show, Sasha is now going solo in syndication. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Now, previously, if you're accustomed to the Atlanta area, much like I have been all of my life, you are familiar with this saturating sound from KISS 104.1 in Atlanta for over a decade with number one ratings in both afternoon and middays. Additionally, Sasha is well known for being the most sought after air talent in the Cox and all the Cox media with the endorsement of millions of dollars annually. Known also for having a face, presence, and personality for TV, Sasha has had her own TV show, otherwise known as Makeover Manor, and she has appeared in The Gospel, R&B Divas of Atlanta, Real Housewives of Atlanta, Living with Faith, Ayala Van Zant's Fix My Life, and recently Lifetime's Lust, produced by Bishop T.D. Jakes. Sasha's new endeavor in her partnership with Gray Television with a new TV show called My Real Life. This show will air Wednesday nights at 8 p.m. Beginning next week, March 29th. So mark your calendars. So listen, with that being said, I would like to introduce to some and present to others the one and only, the awesome and great, none other than class and sophistication herself, Sasha the Diva.
Okay, he's going to get $5 for that. How y'all doing? Make some noise up in here. Okay, it's gonna be starting next Wednesday. So make sure you guys check it out. I am the executive producer, the creator, and the host of the new show that's gonna be on CBS Peachtree's TV. It is called My Real Life. So it is a spinoff of MTV Cribs and Lifestyle of the Rich and Famous. So will we be watching? Can I get a yes? Thank you, darlings. All right, so we're going to have an interesting night tonight. I have a script. I don't follow scripts, so I'm probably going to go off and do my thing. You know what I'm saying? Hey, Chief Ramos, how you doing? You doing good? You keeping DeKalb County safe, right? Girl, you everywhere doing everything. Make some noise for Chief Ramos and ours. Okay, so let me get this script. I got folks walking in, and everyone's getting ready to get seated here. So we're going to have the... Before we do anything, it's always important to start it off in prayer, right? If you believe. Pastor Norman Thomas Jr., who is the senior pastor of First Baptist Church of Gresham Road. Pastor's not here. Oh, it happened. How y'all gonna pray without me? Say it again. Okay, I didn't want to do presentation of colors. I was trying to get my prayer on. Okay, y'all pray without me. All right. So we're going to keep it moving. It is the presentation of colors by the Drew Hills High School Navy JROTC. They are absolutely amazing. So make some noise for the presentation of colors. And if you could please stand, we would ask everyone to stand and remain standing because we will be doing the Pledge of Allegiance, which is also being presented by Drew Hills High School Navy JROTC, which is the mayor's school, yes. The Navy JROTC is comprised of high school students between grades 9 through 12. They have so many objectives that they are hitting, and we are so proud of them because it's just so important in the world that we are in that they have a steady foundation. They are under the leadership of LTCOL Clarence, is it Moraney? Okay. Hey, Mr. Clarence Moraney, how you doing? United States Marine Corps.
Please join me in the pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. You may be seated. Thank you very much.
Can we give a round of applause for our young adults? So I would like to have the introduction of our elected officials, Mayor Pro Tem George Turner. Hi, boo. How you doing? Man, I see him everywhere doing everything. How you doing tonight?
Doing great.
Okay, you take that mic.
Thank you. Good evening, Stonecrest. It's a wonderful day in Stonecrest, and tomorrow is going to be even better because that's what we're all about, getting better. The mayor is very excited about what's happening tonight. She has several family members here and a lot of friends here, and my job is to identify those elected officials who have walked a mile in the shoes that she's now walking in, and they are so beautiful to come out and support her, and I just want to say thank you for your service and thank you for what you do for your community. I'm looking through the audience to try to identify them. They are here. Oh, you have the list?
I'm going to introduce them.
Oh, you're going to introduce them. Why am I here?
No, you do your thing.
Let me just introduce D. Dawkins Hagler, State Representative, past Also, Ms. Deborah Dewberry, Clerk of Courts of Gap County, is here. Larry Johnson, DeKalb County Commissioner. Ms. Marita Davis Johnson is here. Ms. Valencia Smith is here. And with the DeKalb County School System, we have Ms. Vicki Turner. And Mr. DeJean DaCosta, the chair. And I'll take personal privilege to introduce some of our judges that are serving in the city of Stonecrest. And that is Judge Scott is in the back room. Judge Barnes, and our Chief Judge Curtis Miller. I know I missed some, but again, thank you for coming. Thank you for supporting the city of Stonecrest. And on behalf of the mayor and city council, welcome to Stonecrest.
You know, before he walks away, George Turner, you know he retired from MARTA. He was the general superintendent. I got to break it down for him a little bit, okay? He was in District 4, council representative and mayor of the pro team since 2018. 15 years of his life, he served on boards, commissions, associations, coalitions, alliances, volunteering his time to improve the quality of life in DeKalb County. So again, can we give him some love tonight? All right now. And the family is here. Can the family stand up for me? Hey, family. This is her family. Can I have that cordless mic, please? Can I have that cordless microphone? Thanks. Because, you know, a lot of times when you are in certain positions without the family support, it is tough to do what it is that you do. With the long hours and just trying to balance out your life. I see you over there shaking your head, Larry. That's why you've been married as long as you've been married, because your wife has had your backbone, okay? Where's that cordless microphone? Because I need to, they went to go get it for me? Just 1 second. Okay, but the grandmom was here. Hi, grandmom. How are you? Mom is here. Aunties are here. Her son is here. So it's just glad to see the family here and supporting. All right. So we are getting ready to, hold on a second, bring up Ricardo and Xavier. Y'all come on up here. You got the microphone, so I'm going to just bring these two brothers up here.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the City of Stonecrest Municipal Court judges, City Council members, Mayor Cobble's Escort Committee, and the First Family. The Judicial Branch Municipal Court judges, Chief Judge Curtis Miller, Associate Judge Janet Scott, Associate Judge Latasha Barnes, Municipal Court Administrator Ms. Mallory Miner.
Stonecrest City Council, Mayor Pro Tem George Turner, Councilwoman Tara Graves and husband Brian Graves, Councilman Rob Turner and wife, the Honorable Vicki Turner, DeKalb County School Board member, Councilwoman Alicia Washington, Councilwoman Tammy Grimes and husband Mr. Reggie Grimes.
Yes. Isn't this amazing? And I'm so glad to see the room full. Many times we have events like that and community don't even come out. So you should give yourself a round of applause, because that shows that you care about your community and what is happening with the residents. Hey, judges, how y'all doing? I need to get your cards and stuff like that, okay? Just make sure I get in any trouble. I got y'all. Y'all got me? Okay, thank you. Sasha don't do jail well, okay? And I'm not going to do anything illegal, okay? Just so you know. I can tell you that the mayor, God, I met her some years ago, and she has just transitioned to do so many things, and she just loves this community and her family, and she is definitely a trendsetter, all right? She's going to deliver her address via a video right now. It is the video State of the City address. Make some noise.
Hello, Stonecrest. Welcome to the first State of the City Address. I am Jazzmin Cobble, your mayor of the city of Stonecrest. As we enter into this new year, the city council and I wanted to provide you with a recap of our accomplishments from 2022 and a look ahead for what's to come in 2023. When I took office in June, we committed that together we would move Stonecrest forward by creating our culture, which will build a better platform as we restore, rebuild, and reform the future of Stonecrest.
She's here. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, the Mayor's Escort Committee, Acting City Manager, Ms. Gia Scruggs. Chief Judge, Dear Jackson, Superior Court, DeKalb County. Commissioner Marita Davis Johnson, DeKalb County Commissioner, District 5. DeKalb County Clerk of Superior Court, Ms. Deborah DeBerry. The 58th Mayor of Atlanta, Mayor Shirley Franklin. House lights up, please. Ladies and gentlemen, Mayor Jazzmin Randall Cobble, the first gentleman David Cobble, and their son, Master Mason Cobble.
Mayor Franklin, hey. Boy, she was a beast, wasn't she? Woo. I think she started in 2002 when I got to Atlanta. Two terms, and did she change the city of Atlanta? Make some noise. This little woman, yes, just taking over the ATL. So now we will have the state of address that is going to be shown to you by video right now.
Hello, Stonecrest. Welcome to the first State of the City Address. I am Jazzmin Cobble, your mayor of the city of Stonecrest. As we enter into this new year, the city council and I wanted to provide you with a recap of our accomplishments from 2022 and a look ahead for what's to come in 2023. When I took office in June, we committed that together we would move Stonecrest forward by creating our culture, which will build a better platform as we restore, rebuild, and reform the future of Stonecrest. I'm proud to acknowledge that this platform represents a combination of campaign slogans championed by each council member as we pledge to work together as one connected community to take the city to higher heights. It was the City Council's unwavering support to the community and our collective leadership that allowed us to pass sweeping legislation in the last 6 months that ultimately improved the quality of life and enhanced service delivery for residents and businesses as we move Stonecrest forward. Leading the new administration of this great city, we are committed to implementing new laws that allow small businesses to grow and thrive, while at the same time providing individuals and families with resources and support that they need to ensure a brighter tomorrow starting today. To achieve these goals, it was important to assure a solid foundation for the city to stand on. Last year, hello, Stonecrest. Welcome to the first State of the City Address. I am Jazzmin Cobble, your mayor of the city of Stonecrest. As we enter into this new year, the City Council and I wanted to provide you with a recap of our accomplishments from 2022 and a look ahead for what's to come in 2023. When I took office in June, we committed that together we would move Stonecrest forward by creating our culture, which will build a better platform as we restore, rebuild, and reform the future of Stonecrest. I'm proud to acknowledge that this platform represents a combination of campaign slogans championed by each council member as we pledge to work together as one connected community to take the city to higher heights. It was the City Council's unwavering support to the community and our collective leadership that allowed us to pass sweeping legislation in the last 6 months that ultimately improved the quality of life and enhanced service delivery for residents and businesses as we move Stonecrest forward. Leading the new administration of this great city, we are committed to implementing new laws that allow small businesses to grow and thrive, while at the same time providing individuals and families with resources and support that they need to ensure a brighter tomorrow starting today. To achieve these goals, it was important to assure a solid foundation for the city to stand on. Last year, we were able to accomplish this through executing both administrative and legislative priorities. On the administrative side, we set priorities to transition city services from being outsourced to mostly an in-house operation. This meant bringing more than 40 personnel positions to be directly employed by the city. Other administrative accomplishments to note are the augmentation of right-of-way maintenance to increase the frequency of litter pickup and mowing in the interim of the county right-of-way of services. Spending $12 million in repaving more than 58 lane miles of roads. Spending $250,000 in improvements to Salem Park, which is just phase one of a multi-phase approach to upgrading Salem Park. Funding the South River Riverbank Restoration Project. Producing studies on film, entertainment, and music, economic development, freight cluster, bike ped and trails, public works, and the Panola Road improvements. Funding the new Farrington and Miller Grove Park master plans, selling the former Sears building, purchasing the City Hall building, filling over 10 critical personnel vacancies, updating three financial policies, which include purchasing, purchasing card, and financial management, streamlining processes and procedures to making business in Stonecrest more efficient. And in fact, it is the Stonecrest business-friendly approach that has attracted major investments from film and television productions right here to the city. And finally, setting a new agenda packet distribution to allow citizens, city council, and staff more time to review and provide feedback on the agenda items. Additionally, the city hosted several community events to include a paint and sip, Black History Mobile Museum, Easter egg drop, Juneteenth celebration, Screen on the Green, our fall festival, our annual turkey giveaway, and our holiday tree lighting, and to end it all, a night of Kwanzaa, just to name a few. On the legislative side, after listening to our residents, constituents, business owners, and area stakeholders, we passed legislation that will attract business to the area and encourage safety, environmental sensibility, creativity, innovation, and hospitality throughout the city. These laws include the rollback of our tax millage rate, a phase one allocation of $5.7 million of a $9.7 million American Rescue Plan Fund. These are to support education, youth programs, residents, and small business. Decriminalizing 1 ounce or less of marijuana, which eliminated jail time as the only option of penalty and reduced the fine. Supporting women's reproductive rights, proudly honoring the personal health choices of women. Approving wineries and vineyards to be permitted by a special land use permit. Designating that only new for-sale developments are permitted to be built in single-family districts. The construction of for-sale or for-rent communities will be built in multifamily residential districts only. We believe that laws such as these will foster economic development, encourage social engagement, and still maintain the character of our city. As we look ahead into 2023, there will be a second and more expansive transition of services to in-house operations, which will be our Parks and Recreation Services. In efforts to improve the quality of life for our citizens, we seek to improve the park facilities, park grounds, and parks programming for seniors, adults, and youth to include hiring in-house full-time and seasonal employees. Additionally, purchasing equipment and vehicles to handle the maintenance and janitorial services of the city, our facilities, buildings, parks, and right-of-way will provide a significant enhancement to service delivery. To complement the transition of parks and rec services, the 2023 budget includes components of improvements to quality of life and enhanced service delivery throughout all of our city departments. As stewards of the city and its resources, we are driven to act locally but think globally. This means creating a blueprint that positions Stonecrest as the economic crown jewel of DeKalb County. For Stonecrest, that blueprint is our future economic development plan that will serve as the roadmap, guiding strategy for intentional and culturally sustainable economic growth for the city. This plan will set goals that complement the economic development goals within our comprehensive plan, as well as help recruit and retain businesses for a sustainable economic impact. As we solicit input to create the plan, we look forward to hearing your ideas that will help us reimagine Stonecrest as a hub for business, arts, entertainment, and higher education in the region. To continue the improving of quality of life for our residents and businesses, we created two additional code enforcement officer positions. With the addition of these officers, the city can take a proactive approach to code enforcement and compliance, specifically during the evenings, weekends, and overnight hours throughout the city. To ensure that Stonecrest remains competitive, this year we allocated roughly $9.3 million for capital improvements and SPLOST projects, which include transportation improvements, parks improvements, and road repaving, in addition to gateway monuments, bridge and streetscaping, and wayfinding signage. The city's finance department will proactively seek additional grant funding and other resources to support our capital improvement project plan. Finally, we have coined the phrase, "Meet me in Stonecrest," as our marketing slogan for 2023. But we want it to be more than that. The phrase should become familiar words as residents and visitors continue to shop, dine, and explore in Stonecrest. 2023 promises to be bigger and better for Stonecrest. It is the city's vibrant charm that attracts business investments, but it is the sense of our community that makes us a great destination for individuals to live, work, and play. You have placed your trust in the City of Stonecrest elected officials and our staff, and we truly are honored to be your public servants. Remember to stay Stonecrest proud. With your input, it is the collective effort of both Mayor and City Council that moves Stonecrest forward. Let's take an opportunity to hear from our City Council as they highlight their outlook for 2023.
The outlook for Stonecrest is amazing. You know, we're working together to make Stonecrest one of the the best cities. Of course, people can live, play, work.
By having the movie studios in my district, my vision for that is to have an entertainment district or zone, like a studio city, where we can build around those businesses and structure that where we can have hotels and mixed-use residents and things such as that, and then we can have all the supplies and resources that they don't have to go outside of Stonecrest, but everything will be built around them.
For me, the future of Stonecrest is to make it bigger, better place for us to live in. I'm excited about being able to be a part of making sure that my district has more opportunities recreationally, life skills, computers, job opportunities, the things that they would need so that they can grow. I expect it to be one day in the future, a great city that nationwide that everyone will hear about.
One thing we talk about is economic development. The community wants to see more in terms of eating establishments, recreational establishments, and that will only come with an investment in our community by those who can see us growing and supporting it. People come to recreate and enjoy nature and find here things that they can find no place else. And that's what I want us to be, a destination city. Come and see Stonecrest. You will not forget it.
In 2023, I just want to make sure that we are good stewards of the resources that we've been given and believing that we're doing what's best for the city of Stonecrest, the citizens, developers, businesses, all of those who make this place a great place to be so that we all can be Stonecrest proud. That's what I'm looking forward to.
As we continue to move Stonecrest forward, I hope that you will meet me in Stonecrest because the best is yet to come. Remember to stay Stonecrest proud.
I love it. Mayor Cobble, $3 million in residential and small business support grants. How many business owners do we have in the room? Let me hear you make some noise. Yeah, $3 million, okay? $760,000 for police service. $13 million to make our roads better. And it was interesting, I was watching that. You know, the entertainment industry with film is huge in the city of Atlanta. And I have now crossed over into the film industry. I've been working with Bishop T.D. Jakes, Lifetime, BET, Megamind Studios, and I'm on a project right now. And Mayor, let me just tell you what I told them when they first came to me last year. I said, I love the city of Atlanta, but can we just go a little bit further? And we've been in the area of Stonecrest, looking at event spaces and catering services to bring the film industry just a little bit further out here to put more money into your city. Make some noise for this mayor! All right, y'all, we get ready to have some cool conversation. And we're going to have a fire chat, and I'm going to bring these amazing women to the stage. But let me just tell you about this. This one right here. Ooh. Shirley Franklin. That's all I got to say. That's all you got to say worldwide when you hear her name, Shirley Franklin. You know, Shirley Clark Franklin served as the 58th mayor of the city of Atlanta from 2002 to 2010. She led the city to adopt policies and practices to stabilize its finances and adopt ethic legislation to promote public engagement and government decision-making. Over the course of her 2 4-year terms, the city designed and implemented aggressive infrastructure plans for Hartsfield-Jackson Airport, International Airport, affordable housing opportunities, the Atlanta Beltline, clean water plan, the Parks Opportunity Program, and helping the homeless, financing nearly $8 billion. These long-term investments have contributed to a strong local economy and expansion of job opportunities available for the local residents during her 8 years as mayor. Ladies and gentlemen, Franklin is an honorary member of the Delta Sigma Theta Sorority. Make some noise to Mayor Shirley Franklin. Yes, please. Please help her up on the stage. It is an honor. It is an honor. And then, how you doing, beautiful?
Fine, I'm going to walk behind
you. Oh, you're going to walk behind me? She's so little and cute.
No.
Oh, my gosh. She's so cute.
Thank you.
I first saw her, I said, look at her. I want to pick her up.
No.
I just want to pick her up and hug and kiss her.
Know me so well, huh?
Mayor Jazzmin Randall Cobbler, looking good in that red, girl. She was sworn in as the second mayor of Stonecrest June 17, 2022. She was honored and excited to serve as the mayor. Fellow residents, she has a lot invested in this community. She's got her young son here, and you know, that is so important, the quality of life, that is important to her. During her 5.5 years on city council, Jazzmin built a reputation for being real strong and demanding fiscal responsibility, accountability from the city administration. She has dedicated herself to setting up the city government with a foundation that is strong. Mayor Cobble will not be quiet. She will not be silent. She will always speak for what she thinks is best for the community. She's worked in partnership with many fellow city council members to implement what is right for this city. Her and her husband is here today, her parents are here today, her son is here today, and they are residents of Stonecrest for the past 14 years. Please give the love to your mayor, Jazzmin Randall Cobble. Hello, beautiful.
Thank you.
You are amazing. You know what? I'm just looking at you, Jazzmin, looking like Alicia Keys. Doesn't she look like Alicia Keys? It just hit me. These two beautiful women. Okay, so now, are we sharing this one mic, or will they have?
Oh,
they got their cordless on. Okay, excellent, excellent. All right, we're going to have some questions and cool conversation. Mayor Franklin, similar to your first term in office, the city of Atlanta needed leaders to reestablish confidence between government, citizens, and business communities. Now, as you know, the city of Stonecrest has experienced some of these challenges, all right? Can you please talk to Mayor Cobble about the community, both residents and business, what they will need from her?
Oh, wow. So one of the best things to do as an elected official is to talk less and listen more. Mm-hmm. And I don't mean that's because you don't have anything to say, because obviously you've accomplished a lot. But sometimes, what you hear from the community, whether it's in the barbershop or the beauty salon or in the small business or a corporate setting, you don't know. And I found that my listening skills got better when I was mayor. And sometimes that's hard to do because you already know the answer, but you have to kind of hold the answer and let people have their say. And the strategy I used was not to make a commitment on the spot, but I'm famous for saying, let me think about it, so that I could give some real thought and then also do some research on what's necessary to move forward. So I just urge you to use all of the listening skills that I already know you have.
Mayor Cobble, how does that feel that she's saying keep your mouth shut and just listen? I mean, that's basically what she's saying.
Yes, it is. Yeah.
No, what do you think about that?
Yeah, no, I think it's good. It's great advice, I think, not only for politics, for marriage, for family.
Wait a minute, did you say marriage?
Yeah, it's good life advice as well. It is often where you run into citizens and business owners who are very eager to express their excitement or concern, challenges and triumphs equally. And because we have been working so hard on that solution, it is first nature to just tell them what you're doing. You know, this is in the works. We've just had a meeting about it yesterday. We're talking through I think that's fantastic to keep in my mind, that even though I know we're working on it, and that list grows every day, that just to let them air it out can make all the difference in the world.
Mayor Franklin, when you have people that are running to you all the time, residents and business, and everyone is like, I need, how do you balance that out? Because you want to help everybody, but you can't help everybody.
Oh, yeah, you can.
Okay, how do you do that?
Yeah, I mean, some people just want to be heard.
Okay.
And some people want to know that they've told you what's on their mind. Not everyone needs a big solution. Mm-hmm. And you can actually, even when you tell people, I found that in several of my jobs, including mayor, I was the person that could tell people no, mm-hmm. and the folks wouldn't be upset with me.
Is it how you said it?
No.
Okay.
It's that I tried to be authentic.
Okay.
I tried to say, listen, I hear you, but I have these parameters, and I have to operate within these parameters.
Got it.
And therefore, and you wouldn't want me to do otherwise. Mm-hmm. And based on what I know and have learned, I would say to them, my only options are 1, 2, and 3. And you're asking me to do 4.
Got it.
And I know you're going to be upset about it, but I'm being honest with you.
And honesty is the best way, the truth. Now, how many residents and business owners in here just want to be heard? Let me put your hands up in the air. Who wants to be heard tonight? Only 2 people?
People don't admit it until they really have something to say.
Wait a minute. Who wants to stand up if you want to be heard tonight? Come here right now, okay? Come up here. But like, you know the price is right, come on down. You're gonna have to come on down a little quick, okay? Come on, bring her up here real quick, all right? Now don't come up here and say nothing crazy.
No.
Because then I'm gonna have to get security, get right here.
I'm fine, how are you?
All right.
Good to meet you.
Okay, come here.
Hello.
Say hi to your mayor. Come here. See, don't be nervous. Don't be nervous. What is your name?
Marie Colson.
Okay. What do you live and have a business here?
I live in Stonecrest, but I want to build affordable housing.
Okay, so tonight you're going to be heard. Here is the mayor. Say whatever it is you want to say to her tonight in 60 seconds or less, okay? Okay.
Okay. I don't qualify for that,
For that money? Well, ask your question. Say, hey, mayor, I heard, just say it. Let her hear you. You want to be heard. And when you have an opportunity to be heard, you better speak, right?
Yes.
Here.
I need $3 million. I'm trying to build affordable housing.
Security?
Okay.
Okay, so you want more information about the grant money, how to get the grant money, and how to start a business. Is that what you're saying?
Yes, ma'am. Affordable housing.
Absolutely. Okay, make some noise for her.
Yeah.
Now, security, come get her.
That was great.
Come get her. I'm just joking, sweetie. Thank you so much. When you have an opportunity to be heard and someone approaches you, so for someone who's, you know, wanting grant money, what is the best thing for them to do? What do they need to do?
So I would say, Ms. Colson, definitely reach out to William Smith, who I believe is here, is our economic development director. William, are you in the room?
William, put your hand up.
I saw William earlier. He's probably around.
Okay.
But certainly his information is on our website. William is our director of economic development. Reach out to William so he can direct you to the resources that you're looking for, give you the information about your eligibility, not only just in the city of Stonecrest, through the county, through the state, and on the federal level as well. He should surely be a resource to you.
Step one, so I hope you got that, okay? All right.
So I want to add that the mayor is doing such a good job about reaching out. There's some DeKalb County commissioners here, too.
Absolutely.
And that's the kind of, I won't name them. no. But the county can be helpful in that as well. And And that's one of the challenges that every city and county in the metropolitan area is having. So the more people who stand up and say, this is the kind of thing I want to do, you actually create a movement around an issue that sometimes can open doors that you don't know you have. So
absolutely.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
I didn't mean to put you on the spot.
No, we need to be on the spot. You know, we need to, that was great, okay? Mayor Cobble, you know, just from watching the state of city address, it's obvious there's a lot of work that needs to be done in this community. And creating this new city to improve the quality of life and enhance service delivery, how really realistic is it that you're going to be able to accomplish all of this?
Well, Sasha, I'll tell you this. We are going to accomplish the things and the goals that we outlined during my administration. Those goals will have legs that will take years and years and years to grow to its full capacity. But we will accomplish the things that we set out to in my term. It's not really about having a banner of all the things that Jazzmin accomplished. It's about what did we do during my term that helped set the city up for its vitality long after I'm here. If I can accomplish that, if I can set the foundation so that the next mayor and the next generation and the mayor after that and the generation after that can take that foundation and continue to build, then I feel like I've done my job.
Mayor Franklin. Two terms, and you had your list of everything that you wanted to get accomplished. Were you able to get everything accomplished?
Oh, it really wasn't my list, really.
Okay.
I mean, I found the list when I got there. I mean, some of you already know, I'm the sewer mayor, so anything else, getting the water and sewer issues was really at the top of the list. We got a lot done. But I think Mayor Cobble has hit it, the point, the most important point. You don't get it all done. What you get is the foundation that it can be done over years and generations.
Yeah.
And so just a quick story, and I won't name any names, but after I left office, and there have been three mayors since I've left office, so you don't know which one said this, okay? but, you know, some of my friends said, well, the mayor doesn't want to do this, that, and the other. I said, really? I said, that's interesting. And they said, no, they don't want to do that. I said, well, let me tell you, that's getting done. Because we put the foundation in place to get it done. And I also said something else, because, you know, I do have a smart mouth sometimes.
No.
Yes. I said, there are only five people who know how to undo it, and we're not telling. Atlanta Beltline. Mm. There were people who came in and said, I don't want to do the Beltline.
Yep.
You know, now we're 20 years into it. And even the original commissioner said to me, oh, you know, you'll never get that done. And I said, well, we're going to lay the foundation. And so the foundation is what you know, the long vision, that's the most important vision. And I even talked to our current mayor about that. We were at an event, and they were talking about something with the city, and he looked at me, and he said, you like those long-term projects. I said, I do, and guess what? They're the only ones that count. Because the long-term projects are the ones that generations from now benefit. Now, that doesn't mean you don't need to pave the streets and clean the streets and all the basic services. But the heavy lifting is in laying the foundation that you describe, that generations from now will benefit from your work and the work of all the people who follow you. So hear, hear.
Wow. Mayor Cobble, you know, I want to bring this up because when we were in the pandemic, I think we learned a lot. And it was about how to balance in spending time with family. You're a mom, you're a wife, you're in politics, business owner. You have a lot going on in your life. How are you balancing to make sure you're good? What do you do?
Well, I'm a horrible example of balance.
Oh, it's okay. Fine.
I don't have much at all.
None.
No, not at all. Actually, I'll tell you the person who reminds me the most that I need to find it. My husband. Oh,
look at him looking at you.
he definitely tries to keep that in front of me. You know, you have to find some balance. You've got to take a brain break. You've got to power down. It's really hard. It is
hard.
Insanely difficult because there's so much that I know Stonecrest has the potential to be, and I can't turn it off. Mm-hmm. I just cannot turn it off.
Mayor Franklin, can you help her?
No, because I can't balance either.
Okay, so both of them, okay, forget it.
So there you go.
Forget it. What's your husband's name?
David.
David, so what you're going to have to do is you're just going to have to be the one to step up, to take the phone, to have date night, to you cook sometimes. Sometimes you're going to have to tell her she has to cook. She's going to have to rub your feet, okay? You're just going to have to be the one to say, it's time to pause, babe. I need you to relax, all right? Because we need you to be in a good mind, all right? Thanks a lot, Mayor Franklin. Okay. Mayor Franklin, from your experiences as being a mayor, what kind of support will Mayor Cobbler need from the community that will bring this city on the other side of this transition?
Oh, that's a short answer. Grace.
Okay.
You got to give her grace. Not everything is going to be perfect all the time. You know her. You care about her, and you care about the city. We need to give each other some grace. We make mistakes.
Because we don't do that. We don't give us a, right, grace. We make give mistakes.
I don't mean necessarily. I'm just, things happen. Mm-hmm. Who planned the pandemic?
Nobody.
Who plans the ice storms?
Right.
Who plans whatever? You know, you've got to recognize that everything is not going, and she'll tell you even tonight, something wasn't going quite the way she wanted. I say, relax. Don't
what wasn't
the
going
small
right?
Stuff.
The address plate.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
I said, relax. Don't sweat the small stuff.
Yeah.
We're here to do big, audacious, bold, courageous things. Forget the small stuff.
So can I tell you that? Don't be mad at them, okay? So things got, and you know what, I'm like you, things happen, okay, just keep it moving. Oh, we got back on, nothing is perfect. So don't scream at them, scream at me, okay? And I'll take the beating from that, okay? you've made history to be the first Black woman mayor for Stonecrest. That's powerful. What do you say to her about that? It's so important what she has started and how that can end up being for generations to come, this accomplishment.
Well, the key is to be sure that when you leave office, the door is still open for somebody like you.
Yeah.
In other words, that people believe that people like you and people who are outside of the mainstream of traditional American leadership, and we all know who they are. Some of it is race, some of it is gender, some of it is income, some of it is position. It's a lot of things. I mean, to be sure that the door is still open. That was my goal for myself, to be sure that the door was open for somebody just like me to be mayor of the city of Atlanta.
What was that feeling like? I am the first African-American woman to be the mayor of Stonecrest. I mean, how excited were you? Girl, were you in the room jumping up and down? I mean, what were you doing? Tell me the truth. Tell me the truth.
I'm going to tell you the truth. It is heartwarming. But I'll tell you that the only thing on my mind was get the city where it needs to be. It wasn't about anything else. It was seriously, the list of things I knew we needed to get a jump start on. I didn't take a single moment to think of anything else. And I mean that from the bottom of my heart. It has been Stonecrest, Stonecrest, Stonecrest from the day we started this thing. And I had a list that day. I mean, I was at the inauguration looking out like, well, that tree needs to be trimmed. We need to, there was a pothole that we came over on the way here. You know, I mean, there were things literally in the past because I walk the same streets. I drive the same streets. I shop in the same stores. I see the things that everyone else sees. I live the same life. I'm honored to serve this city in this capacity, regardless of race or gender. But I do understand the value of what it means to show other young women, minority women, all across this world, that surely is possible for us to lead a city into its success. And I plan to do that.
What are we doing in your city to keep crime down? And also with, it's, you know, happening all over the country with the police officers, with us, killing us. What are you doing in your city to, for that not to happen?
So today we use our fantastic county partners, DeKalb County Police Department, to serve the city of Stonecrest in our law enforcement capacity. Additionally though, in the next segment of the mayor's progress report, I'm gonna talk a little bit about the $760,000 that the city council gracefully supported in police augmentation through our American Rescue Plan funds. What we'd like to do, since we don't provide the service today, is find a way that we can assist our county partners in getting that police service in a better place for the Stonecrest footprint. That doesn't necessarily mean today that we are prepared to take the service over, but we wanted to come to the city with, come to the county rather, with some options that said, look, we are setting aside some funds in our budget. How can we help? What can we do to be partners to help provide that public safety service, that police service that Stonecrest needs? As we still try to build toward providing the police services on our own, but what can we do in the interim? What can we do today? Today, people are affected. So what can we do as a city to help the county provide that service to our citizens and our business owners in the city?
Mayor Franklin, 2002 to now 2023, a lot of crime. What are some tips that you could give Mayor Cobble on some of the things that she needs to do for her city?
Generally, or on public safety?
Public safety.
So, in my opinion, the first and foremost responsibility beyond honesty, transparency, in city government is public safety. So I believe that you have to spend the time as well as the money and give the resources in order to make that happen. So my advice to new mayors, and she's not quite new, but my advice to new mayors is they need to be in conversation with the public safety officials, hear what they have to say, be in full dialogue with them about what they're seeing and hearing. But I also think you have to be in conversation with the general public about what they think needs to be done. Because most of the time, a police officer shows up after the crime. The whole idea is to prevent the crime. And communities often know what would be helpful in preventing the crime, because they are the ones who live with it and see it, et cetera. So you've got to be open to the kind of community input. And some of that is training communities on safety issues. I mean, I don't know how many people are here today, but about, 25% left their cars unlocked. And then they're going to complain.
Right.
Somebody went in their car. Or a window unlocked. We get comfortable. And we often, those of us who are way over 60, like me, we talk about what it was like when we didn't have to lock our doors.
Mm. Yeah.
Well, it's not like that anymore.
No.
So we have to educate the public, but we have to be open to them educating us as to what the issues are. Most car break-ins in metropolitan Atlanta today are not about finding money. They're not about driving the car. What are they about? You know what? People are looking for guns.
Wow.
They're looking for guns. Guns that are not secured, either in the car, or in the home, or wherever. So I'm not really now talking about anything dramatic with gun control, but keeping it locked, the car locked, and it's safe in either your home or business or in the car is a big deal. So I would say those are some things. If I were mayor today, in today's environment, I would do everything I could think of and then everything anybody else would suggest. So I met, and I know this is a long answer, but I was with some African-American mayors from other cities a few months ago, several of them really good friends. And at the end of the panel, they came up to me and said, what would you do about crime? I said, exactly the opposite of what you're doing. And they said, what do you mean? I said, I'd talk about it every day, all day long. Everybody would know that they could talk to me about what they think the solutions are. I would not wait for an incident to have a conversation. They looked at me. I said, you busy. Now, I'm not talking about you.
No.
Okay? I said, you all are busy ducking and hoping it doesn't happen in your city. And we have to heighten the anticipation that crime can happen so that we can all be safer in the way we operate. In order to help police officers actually fight crime. Now, there's a dozen other things you should do. Early childhood education, career training, non-discrimination, transportation so you can get to jobs. I mean, there's dozens of other things. But we can start with letting people. I said I would talk about crime like I talked about sewers, which was literally all day, every day. And some of you know this, a couple of you know this, for 8 years. And people said to me, aren't you tired of talking about it? I said, but do you know more about it now? Because I talked about it. And then I would go into the community. This is what I told those mayors. I said I'd go into the community and I'd hold town hall meetings. And I'd ask folks, what do you think we should do? And I would be honest with them and say, we don't have all the answers, so I came here. You got some ideas? You got some ideas? I want to hear what you have to say. Because maybe we need to, two heads are better than one, and 50 and 100 is better than one or two. So I would try to get the entire community engaged in crime prevention, not solving crimes after they happen. So now I'm not a public safety person, but I'm not law enforcement, so I don't want anybody from law enforcement to get mad with me. But I was the executive in city government that supervised 5 different police chiefs. So I know a little bit about it. I know a little bit about it. And I would urge Stonecrest to get everybody engaged. Young children should know what it means to be safe when they are out on the playground, what to do when something happens, etc. All the way up to senior citizens like myself. I'm sorry for such a long
you
answer.
You are fine. And like you said, when she said we would do things back in the day, we need to be more involved community. We knew our neighbors. We knew the children. We could say things to the children. A car driving the community that you know is not supposed to be in the community. We on the phone. Who's that car? We don't. It's like we don't care anymore. We go into our houses, shut the door, see the news, and be like, "Oh, did you see what happened?" And you off to your life. It just cannot be like that. We have to go back in the day and care about our community and start speaking up and becoming more involved. That's how it changes. That's how it changes. All right, so for the residents and the business owners here, one more person is going to have an opportunity to speak before we get this last question in from my Mayor Cobble. Anybody want to be heard tonight? Ain't no way I'll be sitting in this audience and I'm not going to be heard. Anybody else want the opportunity? Okay, come here, my love. Come on up here. Mm-hmm. How you doing?
Hi, how are you?
Nice right, go ahead and say hi to her too. That's gone, gone.
I
all
saw
them
yesterday.
Tattoos. Come on, right here. Come on over here with Sasha. Okay, sit right here. So, okay, what is your name?
I'm John.
Don't take the microphone. Don't take the microphone. I gotta control it all, y'all. Hold on a second. Okay, now what's your name?
I'm John Farnville, a resident of Stonecrest.
Okay, are you a business owner here too?
Yes, I am.
What is your business?
Formula One Detail.
Okay, so what do you want to say tonight?
I want to thank Ms. Cobble for coming out into the community. She's the only person of...
Okay, this is what you're going to do. Take the microphone, and you're going to speak to her directly. Go over there and talk to her eye to eye. Don't be... 60 seconds. 60 seconds?
Okay. I can stand for her. Thank you, Ms. Cobble, for patronizing and letting the young men that work for me see you being a part of the community. And that's what it's all about. It's not really all about... It's about money, but it's just being a part of the community. I really think it's supposed to be way more people here tonight. I had to shut down my business early to make it, just to show her support. She support my business, and I'm here to support Ms. Cobble. Thank you.
Hey, hey.
All right now.
There you go.
You were heard. All right, for you. You have Mayor Franklin here. You're 5.5 years in. If you could ask her anything, think about it. What would you ask her? You can ask anything you want. You can ask how many questions you want. She right here.
If I could ask Mayor Franklin any question, wait, I only have one tonight.
You can. This is your city. Okay. Girl, how do you keep that skin looking like that?
I'm good.
You know
whatever.
What I'm saying?
Yeah. Okay. Any question?
Take your time.
Any question? There's so many. I have so many.
And now, you know, as I asked it, I'm sitting over here thinking too. Like,
I've got
what
so many. Okay, I'll start with this one. We are in a transition period, right? We are moving Stonecrest forward together. There is a lot of expectation that transition will happen just within the last 9 months that I've been here. And we work. Hopefully you saw from the address that we are working tirelessly to pull ourselves through that transition. What I find most challenging in that is not the work that we know that needs to be done, right? We know the service improvement areas. We know the quality of life that we're trying to achieve, right? We know that. What I find the most difficult thing to get us through the transition, over the hump, is encouraging my fellow community members to go with us, not against us. What else can I do? What else can I say? How much more encouragement? What other words do I need to use, or less maybe, to help our community understand that we are better than we were? We will be okay, and that we are working very hard to get there. But if we don't do it together, I can't achieve the expectations that are in front of us for me or my council. I cannot achieve those goals if we are not going together. So what else can I say?
Well, that's a great question. And I actually have two answers. The first thing is you don't need everybody to get where you're going.
Did you hear that?
I heard it.
You need some people to get there. And you need them to be with you most of the time. I used to say, and please, counsel, don't think badly of me. But I used to say a unanimous vote from the council was too costly. The rules only call for a majority. I stopped counting when I got there. I wasn't trying to have folk love me. I was just trying to go somewhere, right? Now, that did not make me very popular with the council. At the time, I became more popular later, after I left office, right? But I would say, you know, sometimes you have to go with the folks who go with you. And I think every mayor I've ever known, small town, big city, would say pretty much the same thing. They might not admit it when they were in office, but there's a town called Greenville, South Carolina, and they had a big project to move a river and to build downtown. I don't know how many of you have been there recently. And the mayor was walking me around the city. Oh, this was a decade or so ago, longer than that, really. And I said, well, how'd you do it? He said, well, I had 6 votes on the council, and we stuck together, and we got it done. He didn't say I had a unanimous vote. He even told me that if there had been a poll as to whether the river should be moved and the park should be built and the investment should go into small business, the majority of people in the town would have voted no. And they really didn't like it until the day it opened. So that's one thing. The second thing is you got to have a thick skin. This is really not about whether people like you or not. Yeah. They got all kinds of reasons not to want to go where you're suggesting. Some of it is fear, and some of it is reasonable fear. You know, they don't want to lose. They don't want to fail. Not everyone is the risk taker that you are. So you've got to give them some grace. The way to overcome that, however, is not words. The way to overcome that is to have long-range plans. My solution was every major initiative that we undertook had a 10-year window. I could only serve 8 years. But some of that was because I didn't want the next person undoing it, right? And then with some, I went to a 25-year plan. And I got the council to adopt plans that were 10-year plans. I'm talking about major issues now. And 25-year plans. So the whole idea was to get people invested in the long-term goal. I personally wanted 50-year plans, but everybody thought I was crazy. So I stuck with 25 and 10. So I would urge you, when you see things, it's important to trim the tree. You're absolutely right. You remind me so much of Maynard Jackson. That is Maynard Jackson all over.
Wow.
I mean, really. You know, really.
Wow.
I'm sorry.
I got tears.
He would have had a list. Whoa. We were so glad he didn't have internet and a cell phone. We would have never had any sleep with him. Never. But as important as all of that is, the long range things are what are going to provide the foundation for Stonecrest. And you have a great opportunity. Mm-hmm. You're coming from zero.
Right.
Do you see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So you can describe a vision that's 100 years from now. 100 years from now, this is what we want to look like, be like, feel like. And 50 years from now, and 25 years from now, and 10 years from now. That is a huge opportunity. When you walk into a city and everything is fine, nobody wants to change anything. It's when, I love it. I used to declare a disaster, okay? People would go in and say, well, it's not so bad. I'm like, it's disastrous. It's awful. You know why? Because then they give me more leeway to do something innovative. If things are kind of okay, folks don't want to change. I'm famous for saying, no, 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 this is a war-torn area. We got to rebuild it from the bottom up, right? We got to do it different. So you have a huge opportunity, and I would just urge you to take the opportunities to, you know, to think big, think bold, understand you can't get it all done, but you get things done that people didn't even think were possible.
Girl, I have to ask you, because when she compared you to Maynard Jackson, I got goosebumps. I'm just, you know, you just don't say something like that if she didn't see it. I mean, I see it in your eye. I mean, how did that make you feel? Girl, I want to scream for you. Okay, fine. How do you feel hearing that?
I promised my son I wouldn't cry.
Okay, fine.
So I'm trying to hold that in. But okay. It's humbling, for sure.
It is. Wow.
And, you know, Maynard didn't have everybody with him.
Yeah.
There were a whole lot of people who thought Maynard was moving too fast, too far. Come on, Larry. You know, too bold. People said he was a bull in a china closet, you know, and that he never satisfied. Oh, I'm telling you, he didn't have everyone. Martin King didn't have everyone. I mean, none of the leaders of the latter half of the 20th century, they had small groups of people who went with them. But they had the vision and they had the presence of mind, just like you do, to know you are going in the right direction, and they went with the folk who were willing to go with them.
Yes.
Thank you.
Movers, shakers, thank black you. Girl magic, Mayor Shirley Franklin, the mayor right here, Jazzmin Cobble. Girl, make some noise. Just make some noise for them. This has been like amazing conversation. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. You are a star and you have just done so much, so much. And we learned so much tonight. Well, I will tell you this, that we saw the State of City of Dress video, okay? An
Ms.
amazing thing.
I'm gonna stop you.
Stop me.
I've got a surprise. It's not in your script.
Oh my God, did I have a lottery ticket?
Not quite.
Is The Rock here?
I got something a little bit better.
Is right. Idris here?
Denzel?
Yeah, that's about it.
No, not quite. It's close though.
And can I tell you something?
Sure.
I've had a chance to be around Mayor Franklin when I first came to Atlanta in 2002. She was just moving so much. And she would grace to come on my radio show, and I was always so honored to be around her because she gave the knowledge and just was so nice. And I thank God for you, and I thank you for that. And then when I met you, it was just like instant love. Hey, girl. You know, so.
Girl crush.
And I'm very, very proud of you and all your success and everything that you're putting in to make this happen. So I support you 100%. I don't live in the community, but I'm part of the community. I have a business
we'll
in the community.
You.
And I got you, girl.
Thank
you. You're making it happen.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you, love. Thank
Idris!
You. Okay, wait. I got. He's not here.
Idris?
He's not here,
oh,
but
okay.
I've got something close.
Okay.
All right.
The lottery ticket gonna be it, y'all. Okay, is it a pair of shoes?
I have something for you, Mayor Franklin.
Thank you.
Uh-oh.
If you'll indulge me just a second. So I don't have to tell anyone in here how fantastic you have been, not just for the city of Atlanta, but what you've done for the entire country, certainly for the state, and the example that you've left to so many of us who strive to just have a fraction of the impact that you've had. So as the first recipient of the key to the city of Stonecrest.
Nice! Very nice.
Thank you.
I'm looking over here. Look, I'm going to see.
Oh, this is great.
I want to tell you thank you so much.
This is wonderful.
You certainly did not have to. You didn't have to play a role for me.
That's nice.
But you did. And even though I'm an AKA.
Security?
In Delta Red.
And I'm right. An intensified. I'm an intensified pink.
Oh, Lord.
I want to tell you thank you. I'm trying to keep it together here.
That's okay. Let it go.
No. I promised him I wouldn't.
It's okay.
But seriously, you have been so much. You've meant so much to so many of us. We don't always get a chance to meet some of the folks that we look up to. And you didn't hesitate when I called. You didn't know me from anywhere. But with one conversation, I feel like we had connected. And then since then, I've been just waiting for this day to come. So on behalf of the city of Stonecrest and the Stonecrest mayor and city council, I'd like to present to you my first key to the city.
Thank you.
Wow.
Thank you.
Isn't
it beautiful?
That is nice.
Oh. I don't think I've ever had one that's been beautiful.
Oh.
Thank you.
Let's take a couple of pictures.
Okay. I wonder where my key is. I guess I'll get the second one. Can I borrow yours, Miss Shirley?
No. I have somebody put it down.
Okay.
Beautiful. That was very nice. That was very nice.
Sure.
Okay, we're going to do some photos.
If you'll indulge us just 1 second.
She didn't hear me, though.
I heard.
About my key, but go on, take them pictures, child. Go on, get them pictures, child. Yes, yes.
If you'll indulge
yes, sir.
Us
come on,
just
yeah, come
one
on,
minute.
Come on up. It steps right here for the
and
ladies.
And then we've got one more portion of the program left, and then we'll be out of here, okay? You want to get down? Who's the photographer? Tell
right
us what
here.
To do.
Right.
We're gonna get behind the chairs. Yeah. Right.
Okay.
Are you missing? Oh, Tammy. Tammy left. Yeah.
Thank you all.
1, 2, 3, fabulous. Did you get it? Okay. 1, 2, 3, fabulous. Nice.
Congratulations.
Yes, let's put it back in the box. We're going to make it put it back pretty and everything. That's very nice. Okay.
Sasha.
All right, so we saw the State of the City address video, which was amazing, and it really informed us of everything that the mayor is doing in this fabulous city. Mayor Cobbler and the many members of the City Council, thank you so much for all of your support and commitment. It's not over yet, so if y'all can just like bring it down for a second. Okay, they back there doing selfies. Okay, yes, I'm talking about y'all. Did you get your selfie? Okay, go on, post it up on Instagram, okay? And make sure you hashtag Stonecrest, right? The city of Stonecrest. Make sure you do that. Right now, she is going to present to you her progress report, which is very important to her about what is happening. Ladies and gentlemen, again, our mayor, Mayor Cobbler. Cobble, Lord. I'm thinking about peach cobbler, child.
Testing, okay. I'm gonna use this one instead of this one. Thank you all so very much. I know we're a little bit behind schedule. I have a mayor's progress report that I'd like to show you. And then we'll be out of here, okay? Thank you so much for hanging out with us. All right, nope, we're getting there. Mm-mm. We'll just go through the slide deck. Don't worry about it. Nope, down's going that way. Well. That's it. Mayor's progress report. I took my shoes off to put the flats on. So if you're gonna take pictures, take them waist up. Okay. So I can get through this and walk through it. But they are intensified pink to go with the intensified pink suit. Saros, thank you very much. So the mayor's progress report. So really quickly, I wanted to go over some of the things that you can expect to see coming. A lot of the State of the City address, will you turn this down for me a little bit? A lot of the State of the City address captured some of the things that we've already done. So I wanted to bring a couple of things that you can look forward to seeing coming up in the very near future. So the first thing I want to talk to you about is our American Rescue Plan funds. This fund, most of you probably know a little bit about, but is a federal grant that came to us. This year, we had just announced on Monday the release of our residential and small business support grant programs. So if you are a resident of the city of Stonecrest or a business owner in the city of Stonecrest, you have an opportunity to apply for some grant funds for assistance. We have allocated $3 million, as you can see on the screen, for both the residential and small business support programs. When you get a chance, go to the city's website, stonecrestga.gov. When you go there, go to Stonecrest Forward. Stonecrest Forward is where you will find the applications for the small business grant and the residential support grant. Please, don't leave that information just in your ears or in your pocket. Please share that information with anyone that you come across in the city who you know could benefit from either the residential or business support program. You'll notice we have allocated $2.4 million in parks and recs improvements. $500 of that is to go toward adult and youth program expansion. We just also released the information on our summer camp program. So if you know of any students in the city that would like to attend our summer camp, please do go on our website and find that information as well. $900,000 of that is parkland acquisition, another $1 million in our rec center upgrade. $1.7 million in educational support is also a part of our allocation from the American Rescue Plan funds. That $1.3 million, or $1.7 million, was not only to support the students in Stonecrest, but it was important to us that we made sure that the schools in the city's footprint, and I say footprint because all of the schools are run by our school board, our DeKalb County School Board, our former chair, and also a Stonecrest resident is here with us, Ms. Vicki Turner. But it was important to us that the city was able to make an impact on the students that are in our city and our footprint. So we allocated $100,000 to each of the 12 schools in the footprint of Stonecrest to help with wraparound services. So those funds will go directly to the schools, the 12 schools that are in the Stonecrest footprint. The other $500,000. The other $500,000 is granted to Georgia Piedmont, who is building a regional transportation training facility here in the Stonecrest city limits. to help train our students as they come out of our high schools in logistics and transportation. So we also allocated $500,000 for that project. $750,000 is for intersection improvements. Where is Sarah Gwen? There we are. Sorry, Grant, I wanted to make sure I noted that for you. $750,000 in intersection improvements. We understand in the city that there are some areas of the city that need some real detailed studies on how to improve those intersections so that we, one, can relieve congestion, but also to make sure that they're safe for travel. So we've allocated $750,000 out of our American Rescue Plan funds to study those intersection improvements. That is an addition, Sarah Gwen, to another $375,000 that's coming from our SPLOS fund. So with the two of them together, it's over $1 million to look at intersection improvements in the city of Stonecrest. $760,000 has been allocated for the police service augmentation that we talked about a little earlier. $27,000 for our food disparity, which is food drives across the city, and $25,000 to our Citizens Academy. That was from our American Rescue Plan funds. From our SPLOS funds, our LMEG and our TPD funds, if you want to know the acronyms, see me afterwards. but we are allocating funds for transportation improvements as well as park and tourism improvements. $13 million between last year and this year in road repaving. That is in addition to all of the road repaving that we've already done from the inception of the SPLOS program. So it's $13 million in the last 2 years alone in road paving. $2 million is allocated for bike, ped, and trails for the city of Stonecrest. $1.6 in sidewalk design and construction. How many of us in the city of Stonecrest know there are some sidewalks that we are in desperate need of? So when you hear somebody tell you that we're not looking at it, there's $1.6 for it. All right. I want to see that on Facebook. another improvement, and I'm not going to read them all to you, y'all, because I know we're running over time, but another improvement that I thought I would mention is the $3.3 million that we're putting into our parks. We know that a quality of life is important to our residents. And not only are we working on the business side of things through economic development, but we're also trying to make sure that we have a quality of life in our parks and recreation. So we're putting money toward that as well. You'll see quite a bit of improvements across all of our parks throughout this year between our American Rescue Plan funds and also our SPLOS, LMEG, and TPD. I get this question a lot. What are we doing about wayfinding signs, monument signs, bridgescape, and construction? $205,000 has been allocated this year for the design and construction of wayfinding signs. So when someone asks you, are we in Stonecrest, you can point. You'll see a sign that says, welcome to Stonecrest. All the signage will look the same. We are branding this city into its new transition, into its new day in the city of Stonecrest. Another $75,000 for bridge and streetscaping design as well. We hope that we'll be able to put that those funds toward the DOT project that is here between I-285 and I-20 that we'll talk about a little bit later. Also, believe it or not, there is quite an interest in Stonecrest having festive lights and banners during the holidays. So, in order for us to do that, we had to allocate some funds toward that. You should expect to see that Stonecrest will have banners and festive signs and lights this season. Let's talk a little bit about planning and zoning. The city council is working extremely hard to update our code to make sure that our city codes match the progress and the plan for the future of Stonecrest. We all have already, I'm trying to fix my speaker box back here, y'all, sorry. The city council has already codified what I think is one of the most important processes on our planning and zoning system, which is to require a community planning information meeting as a part of our zoning process. So normally you'll see that that is voluntary. Normally that is the community meeting with the developer is something that's not mandated. What we decided to do was make it so that no citizen in this city could ever say that they were not provided the opportunity to sit down with the developer who would like to bring that project to have that one-on-one conversation. It is now codified in our code that the developer must hold a community planning information meeting prior to that application moving forward. Hashtag community engagement. I want to see that on Facebook too. our future text amendments that are coming up, and this is important to us. We want to make sure that we're streamlining our city code where our licensing, our business licensing, and our alcohol licensing intersect. When we talk about economic growth, and we'll get to economic development in just a minute, when we talk about that kind of growth, we need to make sure that our processes are streamlined. We need to make sure that it's not complicated to do business in the city of Stonecrest. We have standards. We have expectations of excellence. But we want to make sure that through that, it makes sense and it's efficient to get that done. We want to make sure that the business license and the alcohol license intersect. We're also going to redefine our city code about what it is to be a late night establishment, a restaurant, a lounge, and a club. That looks a lot different today than it used to 10 years ago. You could clearly define a restaurant from a lounge from a club. Today, restaurants are offering entertainment experiences while you're dining. It is sometimes very difficult for our business owners to define themselves through our code because it is not relevant for what the world is moving as today. So our goal is to make sure that we realign that definition so it's not complicated for code enforcement or our municipal court to be able to adjudicate when they need to, also for our code enforcement to be able to enforce, but more certainly so our businesses know when they're applying who they are. What are you when you come to Stonecrest so you fill out the right application and have the correct designation? We are also updating the development codes to promote more green infrastructure, things that are environmentally sensitive. We'll make sure that we have low-impact design techniques when possible and that we are ensuring that we are going green where we can, when we can, and encouraging that for our ecosystem. We are also looking into creating an entertainment district. You've heard Councilman Rob Turner speak about that in the city address. Also looking to create an agritourism district. If you don't know, Stonecrest is one of the most, where's Ravonda? Is she still here? Come on, Ravonda. If you don't know, when you are looking for agriculture, tourism, and recreation, Stonecrest is unlike any other. If you have not been through our National Heritage Area, through our Arabia Mountain, if you have not been through there, you are missing out on an impactful part of your life that you need to do. We are, as a city council, going to legislate through agritourism so that not only can you enjoy, our citizens can just enjoy the beauty of Stonecrest, but that we can attract those from around this region who would like to experience that as well. I'll run through the rest of these really quickly. We're updating our sign ordinances, updating our hotel-motel ordinance to allow for more hotels to be built where they make sense. All right. Hashtag where they make sense. Right. If we are going to be a regional destination, if we are going to be a place that attracts folks from all across this world, we've got to have somewhere for them to lay their head and stay here in Stonecrest. If they can stay in Stonecrest and eat, sleep, experience, and enjoy, then we've captured all that they're looking for right here in our 38 square miles. We have to make sure that our legislation matches that mission by updating our code to make sure that our hotels and motels are placed in the right areas. We can assure that we bring that experience all together in one place. Last but not least, we are working, Ravonda, on our tree ordinance. We will have a tree ordinance that preserves the green space and the trees that need to be here for our community to thrive and prosper, but also make sure that when developers have to remove trees, that they're doing that in the right way. They're not clear cutting, but yet they're following our code to a T to make sure that we are preserving what we can where we can. I'm going to get in the right direction before it's over. Economic development. Hopefully you've heard by now, and you'll see that picture right there on the screen, that Stonecrest is the recipient of a MARTA transit hub. We are calling it the Stonecrest Transit Hub. Hopefully, if you have not heard about that, you can certainly look that up. We had a fantastic press conference, not only with our partners in MARTA, but also our Congressman John Ossoff and Senator John Ossoff, Congressman Hank Johnson, and Senator Warnock. That transit hub is huge for Stonecrest. When we talk about growth, when we talk about the city of Stonecrest being this regional destination, this place where we can grow for years and years to come, we have to talk about transit expansion. There's no way around it. There's absolutely no way around Stonecrest achieving its goals without transit expansion. However, we want to make sure that we're doing that responsibly. We understand the preservation of character area very clearly. But it is impossible to grow if we do not expand transit. The transit hub will give us the ability to bring multi-modes of transportation services into the city of Stonecrest to achieve the last mile gap. More than $1 million, way more than $1 million, is a multi-million dollar project partnering with MARTA and our federal elected officials. I'm just moving through this thing, y'all. That will bring that MARTA hub to life. If you have not read the articles on what a transit hub means to a community, I beg you to go do that. When you talk about changing, literally changing your community overnight, transit is the way to do that. I'm gonna get off that now. Our economic development plan and our steering committee, you heard a little bit about that in the city address. It is really important to us that as we move through economic growth, that we are doing that with a plan where there's intentionality in how we achieve that economic growth. It's one thing to just grab at everything that's out there. It's another thing to have an intentional purpose for the economic growth that you're looking for. It's also another thing to do that at a pace where you can absorb the growth, where it doesn't seem abrupt, where it doesn't seem like all of a sudden you look up and your community looks completely different than it did the day before. We do that with pace. We do that with intentionality so that we can achieve those goals, so that the long-term goals that Mayor Franklin was speaking about, the 10 and 15-year goals, we can achieve that because we know it, because we can see it in the plan. Our economic development plan is already underway. We have a steering committee of stakeholders and residents working alongside our economic development director, who I spoke about earlier, Mr. Smith, who's working through that economic development plan. He's in the back of the room if you want to talk to him a little bit more about the economic development plan. When I tell you that it is important for us to have a plan, and I know sometimes it seems like government, all they do is plan. You just plan, and you never execute. But if you don't have a plan, what you'll have is a community that you can't identify. What you'll have is a community that has been taken over and you can't seem to figure out where the beginning or the end is. For us, we want to build and grow Stonecrest, but it is with intentionality. It is with purpose. They say beggars can't be choosy. Well, we don't think we're beggars. So we're choosy. We will choose what comes here that will sustain our community long after we're gone. Let me move really quickly to the DOT I-285/20 project, because I think this is important for us to be prepared for as a community. And I'm going to skip here. No, I'm not. All right. Okay, I'm not. I had pictures. I don't know where they went. The I-285/I-20 project. Here we go. I put it in the wrong order. I apologize. The I-285/I-20 interchange project with DOT is important for us to keep in mind as you start to see things shift in Stonecrest. What that project will do for us is open the congestion from I-20 and 285 where that intersects. And we're doing that by, one, redoing the interchange, literally that interchange between I-285 and I-20. But also it carries down through the exits that are the city of Stonecrest. The first exit into the city is Panola Road. Panola Road will be transformed, a diversion of sorts. You've seen Jimmy Carter, you've seen Ashford Dunwoody, a diversion to be on Panola Road. Now, this is a DOT project, so don't get me on Facebook sending me all the pictures of what it should look like now. Okay, this is DOT, all right? We're partnering with DOT. But the idea is that Panola Road will become less congested so that we can get on and off of that exit and we can get through our city more easily. The next one is Farrington Road Bridge. If you are on Farrington Road and you understand that when you go down Farrington Road to get to DeKalb Medical Parkway, you go down and you go to a little curve. If you want to keep going right, you hang this sharp right. If you want to go left, you hang a sharp left and then a sharp right. Okay, so DOT is going to back that bridge up. So now that Farrington Road Bridge will align directly with DeKalb Medical. So when you come across the bridge, you will be let out onto DeKalb Medical. When you get to that light, you'll be able to choose to go straight, make a left on Hillendale, or make a right. You are no longer going down and around, hang a left, hang a quick left, I hope you get by, okay? That will relieve congestion there. Back up a little bit. Before you get to Panola Road, there's the Miller Road Bridge. That's where we see a lot of our freight going through that Miller Road Bridge, which is very difficult. That's where it lets the trucks off into our communities, our surface roads, which is why we're doing the intersection improvements, Argwin. The Miller Road Bridge will also be done over so that there's less congestion there. A companion to that, so that you understand how the city and the county and the federal government, the state have to work together, we are doing our freight cluster study. I know it's another plan, but walk with me. The freight cluster study gives us the ability to reroute trucks to a path that has less impact on our surface roads, less impact on our neighborhood roads, keeps them on the roads where they should be. The $12 and $20 million of road paving we're investing into our roads, the heavy trucks on those surface roads are tearing our streets apart. With our freight cluster study, it will redesign where and how freight moves in and out of Stonecrest. We know we have two industrial parks here in the city of Stonecrest, but to make sure that we are getting logistics in and out quickly so that you can get your Amazon package today that you ordered this morning, that you're wanting to come this evening, they have to be able to get in and out. We want them in and out easily so that the business can prosper, but also so that our community roads are still in good and in decent repair. Okay. So this is a project that is coming. So I say that because when you start getting in traffic, because DOT has blocked off, okay? Don't come to City Hall picketing, all right? Don't put your signs up saying we're trying to make improvements. As we make improvements, there will be some uncomfortableness, okay? There will be a little bit of inconvenience at the moment, but now you understand the vision. Thank you, Mayor Franklin. You understand the long-term vision. So when you wake up that morning and you didn't plan for DOT to have shut down the ramp to Panola Road and you've got to go down Panola, hang a left on Covington to come back over to Miller, pray. Okay. All right. We good there? Okay. I want to tell you a little bit real quickly about, come on, get there. Oh. All right, I'm going to stay here. A little bit more about our hospitality and tourism. I thought this was an important visual for us to see. People say to me sometimes, you're talking about changing your code to allow for the hospitality and tourism industry to grow, but what do you have in Stonecrest? Why would someone come? And you know, I can tell them a day long about why they should come to Stonecrest, but I want you to see this in the numbers. These are our hotel numbers. We were able to get this data from Discover DeKalb, who serves as our Convention and Visitors Bureau. Look at the yellow line. That is the Stonecrest occupancy of the Stonecrest hotels. Do you see how high that is compared to the rest? This is current. This is today. This is without any growth, without any projects, without anything coming to its completion. This is what it looks like today. Imagine what that will be when the rest of our plans come together. So when you hear someone say, there's nothing out there in Stonecrest, I expect for you to have a response. I expect for you to be the champions of our success. I expect for you to carry the conversation that we carry. Oh no, there is plenty to do in Stonecrest, let me tell you. We are coining the phrase, meet me in Stonecrest. When you hear those things, be the champion of our success. Let people know what it is to do here and what's to come. Build hope, be inspirational, and most importantly, be the champions of Stonecrest's success. I just thought that was important for us to see, that we are okay. Stonecrest tourism by the numbers. The nights booked in Stonecrest total from January to December of last year was 3,421. 3,400 nights booked in the city of Stonecrest last year. Not this year, last year. Before any movement that we've completed just alone in last year, 3,400 nights, that gross booking, half a million dollars, $528,000 in gross bookings just with the hotels we already have. That's coming out of the pandemic. That's still people being a little bit nervous about, do I go or do I? Already $500,000 put back into our community. Imagine what that number will look like when we achieve just half of what we have planned. So when someone asks you, what is there to do in Stonecrest? You darn sure should be able to tell them. Community and cultural center. It's important to us that we stay in touch with the needs and the wants of our residents. So we're creating more citizen engagement opportunities. I talked about one through planning and zoning, which is that community planning information meeting. It's an opportunity to be engaged in what we're doing. We're also working on a citizen engagement app. It won't look exactly like that, so you know, don't screenshot that and put that on Facebook, but it's gonna look very similar. It's an application that helps you stay engaged with the city. Most of these services are already offered on our website, but we're gonna implement a citizen engagement app that allows you to have that access right in the palm of your hands. That was actually budgeted in last year's budget, which means we were already planning for that. You should see that come to life this year. Of course, all of our social media and website have this information as well. One thing I want to encourage us all to pay attention to and try to find time for it is to be a part of our community committees, our boards and our authorities. There's a lot of conversation on social media, but there's never a presence at a meeting. There's never that same presence at a council meeting. There isn't that same presence at a planning and commission meeting. There isn't that same presence at a committee meeting. Let's come together. Let's be connected. Get ourselves involved in these community engagement opportunities so that you have a voice at the table. We always want to stay customer focused. I'm going to move through this fast, y'all. I know I'm talking about it. There's so much that we're doing. One of the most important parts about being customer focused, I talked about this a little bit earlier, is streamlining our processes so that they're efficient. This year, we are implementing a new ERP system. I'm gonna tell you what that is. This ERP system allows us to automate most of the services that we provide all in one place so that you can see all of the transactions from each service all in one place. This is a huge undertaking. It usually takes 16 to 24 months to implement. We are starting that this year, the first phase of that ERP system. When I tell you that it's gonna make things make sense for the business community and for our residents, will you be able to see all of the permitting information, all of our finance information, all of our code enforcement? You'll be able to see all this information across multiple departments all in one system. It takes a long time to implement, but when I tell you that it's gonna make it easier and more efficient to do business in Stonecrest, to be a resident in Stonecrest, it's gonna be worth the wait. Last but not least, I wanna tell you about our professional first class Stonecrest standard. We are working very hard to be the new Stonecrest standard of excellence. That starts at home with us. That starts inside of City Hall. I have challenged all of our staff members to make sure that we are knowledgeable, we are competent, we are dependable in the services that we are delivering to our residents and our business owners. If we cannot be what we're asking you to be, then why are we there? It's important to me that we start inside of City Hall and make our way inside out. So I've asked our staff to make sure that when they are dealing with our residents and our business owners, that we are doing that with the utmost professionalism as possible. We recently had a customer service training for all of our staff, mandatory. That customer service training was important for our staff to buy into the Stonecrest standard of excellence. If we are not exemplifying the Stonecrest standard of excellence, how in the world can we ask you to? So please know that we are working every day, inside and out, to be the best Stonecrest we can for you. I'll say this last thing about this slide, then I'll move on. We have a total of today 58 employees in the city of Stonecrest. We went from last year having none. They were all privatized. They were all outsourced. Our city manager and our CFO were the only two that were city of Stonecrest employees. We have 58 now. 58 city of Stonecrest direct employees. It took us about a year or so to bring everybody over. 58 direct employees, that's important to us. Making sure that we are only serving one God, the God above, but then just the city of Stonecrest. We felt that it was a better buy-in to where we're going if we had employees that were directly employed by the city. So we went from privatizing those services to them all being in-house, and now they all belong to the city of Stonecrest. Thank you. You heard me mention it in the city address that we have also began evening, weekend. Well, we will begin all three of these, but we've thus started weekend code enforcement. The idea is that we will have weekend, evening, and overnight code enforcement as we prepare to bring on public safety or police services in the future. We needed a way to be able to at least provide that code enforcement outside of Monday through Friday, 9 to 5. So now our code enforcement has just started doing weekend, evening code enforcement. So that means a lot for both our residents and our business owners. So let me level set. Code enforcement does not discriminate. If your house has a vehicle in its driveway that is disabled, you will get a violation, all right? No matter what time of day it is. On the same side, if you are running a business without an alcohol license, you will be shut down, all right? We are equitable in our Stonecrest standard of excellence. We expect that if our government is working hard to be that we are a connected community, that our residents, our government, and our businesses will all operate with that Stonecrest standard of excellence. I often hear a comparison, and I won't mention the cities, but I often hear a comparison, well, they do this over there. I like that over there they have. The only way for us to be what we think we want in other places is if we start with ourselves. If you want to look and be clean and you want our city to be attractable like the one that you venture off to, you must practice what they practice here. That goes for our residents and our business owners. If you want to look like them, we have to practice that here on both sides, both residents and business owners. So I'm just, you know, getting real with everybody tonight, okay? When I send code enforcement to the Salem Road Plaza, okay, you with me right now, dear? When I send code enforcement over to the Salem Road Plaza, because your favorite brisket sandwich is coming off that barbecue pit, the one you go to, 3 o'clock every Saturday afternoon, because you know it's hot. When I send code enforcement, and I say I, but they're doing their job. It's not Jazzmin sending them. Hashtag. She's doing it. When code enforcement goes down to the Covington Highway, Panola Road, Plaza, because there's someone selling Valentine's Day baskets in the parking lot. When you go to Farrington Park on a nice spring day, and they're selling brooms, socks, and laundry detergent. Code enforcement is going to do their job. Because if we want to be the excellence that we see everywhere else, we have to set that standard. So when you see or when you hear your fellow residents upset because code enforcement issued a ticket for the Easter basket sellers and the tube socks millionaires, you should say, we are striving for a new Stonecrest standard of excellence. And we're carrying that across the board. If we come across a business that does not have its proper permits, we're doing the same thing. I just want you to know, that in order for us to meet that goal, we have to work together at it. If we want to be the community that you compare to others, we have to practice that at home. All right, last but not least, the City Council is getting ready to decide on a city flower and a city tree. I am wearing the sunflower pin. The sunflower symbolizes what's on the screen, loyalty and admiration for its beauty. It brings joy and spiritual renewal. It draws attention to our environment and promotes conservation and sustainability in the city of Stonecrest. In order for us to have that connected community feel, in order for us to be champions together, we felt it was important to identify the items, the things out in the earthly world that bring us together. We think the sunflower represents that. The bald cypress tree symbolizes strength and longevity. It can grow to for 600 years. When I think of the city of Stonecrest, and I hope you do too, I think that it will be here forever. Jazzmin will not be here forever. But the city should. The things that we do today should outlive all of us. Our city should have prosperity and vitality long after we're all gone. The Bald Cypress represents that as it grows to be almost 600 years old. We feel those two represent what we think the city of Stonecrest embodies: joy, spirituality, longevity, and strength. City Council has to vote on that on Monday, so go to the council meeting and voice your opinion. All right, I'm going to move through this. Meet me in Stonecrest. Go on our website, y'all. We have so much going on between our city council and our Parks and Recs department by bringing citizen engagement opportunities right to you. Just tomorrow is our deadline to submit, to donate, prom drip. We're donating prom, both for males and females, prom attire to the students in the city of Stonecrest and our four high schools. You can drop that off at our Parks and Recs Rec Center, Brownsville Rec Center, tomorrow, and then we have that giveaway on Saturday. We are excited to be able to really be in touch with our students in the city of Stonecrest, and we think that this is a good way to just to make sure that they know that we're here for them and when they're supporting them. I'm going to flip through these real fast, but if you go to our website or our social media, we have a lot of opportunities. I put these in here because I wanted you to see how much work we are putting in to build this city to be a better Stonecrest than we've ever been before. If you'll go to our website and follow all the things that we're doing, just be engaged, y'all. Stay engaged with us. Be champions of our success. Let people know what we're doing, and I promise you that you will be excited for what's to come. I want to thank tonight our sponsors. A Privy facility has been so gracious to host us here tonight. Mr. and Mrs. Irons, thank you so much. I'll tell you, when this is ready for its grand opening, it surely will be something that will be Meet Me in Stonecrest worthy. Dope Coffee was out in the lobby for you. Dope Coffee is also a sponsor today. Dope Coffee is one of our newest Stonecrest businesses. But what they have going in being black-owned coffee curators, something you don't see anywhere else, something you won't find anywhere else, and they're here in the city of Stonecrest, so we're excited to have them as sponsors as well. Let me thank you, because I'm going to wrap this up, y'all. Let me thank, first of all, our fantastic Stonecrest City Council. If you will, please. I am only one person, but it is the support of our City Council that moves these things forward. I can talk all day long, and they say that I'm the reason why the council meetings go so long. But it is with their support that we're able to achieve these goals. It's with the aligned vision and the support behind it that we can achieve this. So thank you so much for all that you do, all the time that you commit to us. And thank you to your spouses, and your family and friends who allow you to spend so much time with us. To our municipal court judges and our administrator, thank you so much for what you do, helping to provide that quality of life, making sure that folks understand that Stonecrest standard is important to us. So what you do means a lot to us. To our Stonecrest employees, if you're a Stonecrest employee and you're still hanging out with us on a work night, would you please stand up so we can give you a round of applause for your commitment to our Stonecrest standard of excellence. Y'all, these 58 folks are working their tails off every day, and I can't thank them enough. To all of our federal, state, county, and elected officials, thank you for your support of Stonecrest. It is only with your partnership that we are successful. It is only with the ability to call on you when we need you, to give us advice, to be partners, especially in the services that we collectively provide. We surely will not be successful without you. So thank you so much to our federal, state, and county elected officials, to our community partners, both in civic and in labor. Thank you all so much for being here and being a part of the Stonecrest movement. Surely it is not without you that we would do this as well. It is a connected community that truly takes us forward. So thank you so much. I see you, Britt. Of course, Rita as well, for your commitment. Lance, I see you as well. Thank you so much for your commitment to Stonecrest. Our faith-based community, you know it is not without prayer that we will be all that we strive to be and more. I can't thank you enough for the faith-based community for keeping us near the cross, keeping us prayed up, and being a shoulder for us to lean on. Thank you, buddy, for, I'm sorry, Norman Thomas, for always being willing to stand with me when I need you the most. Thank you. I'm almost through. Not going to do it. All right. Finally, to our business owners, to our residents, and to our family and our friends, y'all, please know that we are working so hard every single day.
Take your time. She just started. You know the song "Made the Work I've Done Speak for Me"? Girl.
We are working tirelessly to make you proud. If grace is all you have to give, we'll take it. I want you to know that we are every day thinking of what's best for Stonecrest. How do we get to the place we know we can be? We believe that it is with all of us working together that we can achieve that. So I want you to know when you leave here, I want you to feel it in the pit of your stomach that we are working to give you everything you deserve and more, to give you the quality of life that we know you deserve. And if you'll just be with us, walk with us, be patient with us, give us both your positive criticism and your grace, we will get there.
Yes. Whew. Girl. Can I tell you, I don't live on Chris. But Mayor, I'm moving to Stonecrest. You are amazing. Please give her another round of applause. If you can come to the stage, we're gonna have our closing remarks by Acting City Manager, Miss Gia Scruggs, and our benediction by Pastor Jasper W. Williams Jr. from Salem Bible Church. You can come to the stage.
Good evening.
Oh, it's so bad.
I just want to pause for just one moment. When you have a mayor and a council that will believe in their own vision, in their own words, it just makes nights like tonight special for the whole city of Stonecrest. I want to thank everyone for attending tonight's event. I am Gia Scruggs, the acting city manager of the great city of Stonecrest. And as you can see, the mayor and the council are working hard to deliver for the residents and businesses of the city of Stonecrest. The mayor just walked away with saying to you, but expressing to others her commitment and hours of work and loyalty to this great city. So the tears that you saw, that's just the work that she's doing. That's the commitment that she has to this city. And I think we just have to be proud to have a mayor and a council that will work together and have that type of commitment. And when she says it's every day and she can stand and work all day long, that is the truth. Our goal here at the city of Stonecrest is to provide those enhanced service deliveries and improvements to the quality of life so that we can all experience the best of Stonecrest. Setting a new Stonecrest standard of excellence will ensure that our city has the vitality for many years to come. And I just want to say to Mayor Franklin, anytime we can, and I'm just going to take a moment of privilege, so please bear with me. Anytime I can be in the presence of a legend, of somebody who has paved the way, who may not have made the way any easier, but certainly have given us the hope that no matter what it is that we want to do, that if we listen more and talk less, if we take the opportunity to be heard, if we put a foundation in place, if we look for balance and give each other some grace, you don't have to have everybody to get where you're going, but you should go with the people who are willing to go. And so I say to you, it was an honor to be in your presence tonight. In closing, I want to ask our pastor, Jasper Williams, to please come forward and give us the benediction for the evening. Thank you.
Test. May we bow our heads in words of prayer. All wise, eternal, and everlasting God, thou who rules and superrules our world, thou who rolled this terrestrial ball into space, baptized it with a liquid mist, ordered a variety of blooming flowers, transfigured into a marvelous attraction. O God, these are days, a time when our society is being torn by degradation as it flirts with doom and disaster, a time when sharing seems to be a rarity. High-mindedness runs our streets like a mad dog and beats in uncertain paths. Selfishness has evaporated the milk of human kindness, while pain and panic chase each other like June bugs in the summer sun. We come to you tonight to say much obliged to you for this city of Stonecrest. Thank you, God, for all 54,665 who occupy and populate these grounds. Most especially are we grateful tonight for the great and unwavering leadership that Her Honor Jazzmin Cobble and our city council have so elegantly provided we, the populace of Stonecrest. We come to you tonight, God, with grateful hearts for such excellent leadership during these critical, topsy-turvy times of our society, a time when some say we ought to be pro-choice, others say no, we ought to be pro-life, a time when some say we ought to be able to pack our guns for our personal protection, while others say no, gun violence will ultimately erode and destroy our society. A time when some say we must raise our debt ceiling so that our nation can pay all of its bills, while others say no, let old glory default on its debt. A time when, quite frankly, O God, none of us really know just what to do. But what we do know is that you know, because all power is vested in your hand. And that even when a council member sees the solution one way, another council member sees the solution another way, when Her Honor Cobble sees it yet another way. And each are saying, no, we should do this, that, and or the other. It is through you and you alone, O God, that can take all of the differences of opinion. Only you can pull them all together in love. Only you can give them a peace that surpasses all understanding. Only you can stop them and let them study war no more. May the work of Mayor Cobble and our city council speak for them when they are resting in their graves. Nothing can be said. May the work they have done speak for them. God bless Stonecrest, city that we love. Stand beside her, guide her through the night with the light from above. Now for you personally, if you will, just comfortably position both of your hands for receiving your benediction, your blessing, as we go down from this place. Turn palms in to you. Spirit of the living God, is fall fresh on me. Palms out, go away from me. Palms in, fall fresh on me. Say that with me. Spirit of the living God, fall fresh on me. Now may God give you health in your sickness. May he give you wealth in your poverty. May God be gracious to you and yours. May he smile upon you, lift you in countenance unto him and him alone. May the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God, the sweet communion of the Holy Ghost, may he rest, may he rule, may he abide in your life, now, henceforth, and forevermore. Let every saint of God say, amen. Amen.
The Stonecrest Podcast.
Spreading awareness within our community.